Find these video tutorials helpful. If so, go ahead and hit the donate button at the bottom of the screen at any time, and feel free to donate to your artists, musicians, and teachers. If you're younger than 18, please ask your parents to help you with this, and above all, enjoy these tutorials and have fun. All right, Fishbone, Bonin in the Boneyard. Fun song to play. Norwood Fisher, crazy good bass player. Highly stylized bass player. I think he's the only person that sounds like him. Really cool sound. He gets all kinds of strange sounds out of his bass. Really interesting guy. So anyway, I'm going to show you what I do. And again, none of these are ever perfect, but these will get you to fake your way through it at least. And I'll get you through the main lick, which is, I think, pretty close to being right. So here's what it is, and then I'll show you a couple of variations that I played and I hear sometimes, and you know, he probably varies it up. I just kind of stick to one thing, but anyway, so you have this F, and then a mute to a pop, okay, enough to get you going, and then you have, after that, you have a hammer on B flat to C, a mute, and then a pop. To an E flat. So again, you're gonna thumb the B flat. Okay, so you put that together. And then then you can add the next two notes, a mute thumb to a pop to an F. Okay, that's the first variation. Actually, I usually do a hammer-on. Okay, so you have. So that's a B flat to a C. And then you do a bunch of hammer-ons with a mute thumb to an E flat. So you have B flat to C, mute, pop. And then I do the last one to an F. So one more time, slowly, F to F pop. Okay, which brings you to the second part of the lick, and I'll show you a variation on the first part, but the second part is a little more complicated because there's a few more mutes in there. You have a F to F pop again. Starts off the same. Except you add the B flat, so you do the hammer on B flat to C, mute, E flat, mute, F, mute, B flat up here. So second part again, putting it together. Then there's two mutes, and then a hammer on B flat to C, mute. To an E flat. Okay, so putting that together. And then there's two mutes there. And then I hear a B flat to an A to a mute, A flat to a mute, to a muted pop. So a lot of times he doesn't pop the A flat and the G, so he does B flat. I'm sorry. Okay, B flat, A, mute, thumb, thumb. Okay, so the second part of the lick, very slowly, you have F to F. Time. Okay, and so when you put that together very slowly, the first part and the second part, on the first lick, there are a couple variations you can do. And do two mutes there, and then do the hammer-ons. And sometimes I think he does that. So it just sounds a little different, but occasionally I hear a hammer-on there, so that's why I do it. There's something going on there that's a note. It's not just two mutes, or even just a B-flat to a mute. Sounds cool. This is the one I do. Okay. I also sometimes think he sits on the B flat. And then. So that sounds like this. Okay. When you put it together. So there's like the three little variations on the first part of the lick. There is a variation on the second part of the lick too, which I almost forgot. So you have this, you have the gets to that B flat, A, E flat, C. So octaves. Okay, so again, getting that to work for you. So those are the variations. So I'll do the lick twice slowly, and vary the second part of the lick each time. So the first time I'll go down, second time I'll go up, and it always ends on an L. So you have this. So that's the first part of the lick, and that'll get you through most of the song, and we'll move on. Okay, next, the solo, and this is again where he's just a crazy bass player, and he gets all kinds of cool sounds that I don't know exactly how he gets. He gets these little sounds, these like little grunts in there, and it's just really cool, kind of amazing. Really, really cool stuff. So here's what I hear him doing. So when he does the funky bass, you have, of course, you're on low F. Okay, and I'm gonna do this very slowly. There's an A flat to a G to an F. So the hardest part, I think, is to figure out the rhythm on this. Is a hammer on to an A flat. And then a little F to G. That, so he does that twice. Does he changes the rhythm, it's a B flat to a C. He does like an F sharp there, he jumps down a tritone. Okay, and then he does two more Fs. So very, very slowly. Again, the notes are basically F, A flat, G, F, A flat, G, F, B flat, C, F sharp, F. And so that's the way I split it up. So that's the first part of the solo. So the second part, he does the FF, a little mute, and that's E flat. And the notes here are basically going to be these octaves, E flat, D to D, C to C. Okay? And again, I hear him do this, so I guess. So there's kind of a mute. If you want to do a quick D to D, you can. And then again, it's. And I think he kind of actually hits a mute there, so. But it's just basically those octaves. That's the hammer on B flat to C with a mute thumb and a mute pop. And that's on the G string. So. And the cool thing he does, and he's really good at, is keeping that low note going. okay? And so just putting that together. And again, it's just that. Which brings us to the third section of the solo. Again, just two Fs. And I hear another pop. And I hear him slide up to an E flat, to an A flat, to a G. And there's a mute thumb in there, so it's E flat to an A flat, thumb mute to a D. So that's it there. So you have this again, F, F, pop, G, pop to a D, pop, A flat, and there's a hammer on that after you do that D. Hammer on to an E flat, and then he changes the rhythm around. And does two pops of the mute on the G to a D flat to an E flat. D natural to an E flat. And then I hear A flat, B flat. I'm sorry, A natural, A, B flat, A, G, F, F. I might be at B flat to A, B flat, G, F. I forget. It's one of those. You can turn around, look at what I played on there. It's A and B flat. So again, that third part, slowly. That E flat going, and I didn't there. That is B flat, A, B flat, G, F, F. Okay, which brings us to the fourth little section. And there's a number of ways to do this. I just do it this way. It's an E flat with a B flat and an E flat. So you just thumb, hammer on, pop, thumb, pop. And then you could do a double thumb, 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 pop, thumb, thumb, pop. If you want, you could do thumb, thumb, pop, pop. That stuff. Okay, so you can do the triplets either way. So again, you have this a triplet, thumb, and then thumb pop. The trick is to keep this going at a constant rate. So you're just basically keeping this going with it. And the trick then is to hit the four Fs after it. So again, that's the fourth part of the solo. Okay, and just trying to get it to stay cleaned up. All right, fifth part, you hit four Fs. This is similar to the beginning. And then I hear him do this A flat to G, and then F to A flat again, and then quarter notes G, A natural, B flat. Okay, so then he does. An F to an F. And I hear him slide B flat to C. An octave, C, and a mute. So. And then I hear him do an A flat, G, F, with a rhythm. So, that's kind of the sixth part of the solo. Then I hear him put the pops on one, F to F, and then an E flat to an E flat, and then a D to an A flat. Something like that. And you don't have to really hit those that hard, that pop. So it's that gives that grunt sound in there. And when you go fast, it's actually easier to not pop the note very much. It's kind of hard doing the slow. Anyway, so you have, again, you're turning the pops around. And then I hear him play A to B flat. And then he does a G, A flat, G, F. So when you put the sixth part all together, let's see, you have this. And then he does, to get out of the solo part, I just do this. I add F, hammer on, mute, or F. Turns that into a B flat to a C with a C to a mute. So you have B flat C, hammer on, thumb the C, mute the G. And then you hammer on the F to get you back. So I'll try to do the solo really, really slow. See if I can. So you have, let's see. Something like that in there. So there's the solo section, and that'll get you through pretty much everything. I hope this helps. It's a little crazy. And again, if you hear something better, do it. But it's a great song, fun song to play. Have fun.